Station one, you're working independently. You have scratch paper, pencil, your iPad timer, and your stack of 12. And then you are working on whatever you choose independently. You could work on only the 333. You could work on only the cycle. You could work on all of them. It doesn't matter to me. So let's say I go, okay, I'm gonna first work on the 333 and get my best time. That's what your scratch paper is for, to keep track of your times until you get your best time. When you're satisfied with your best time, you can get a marker and put it up here. So your name will only appear once on a piece of paper. You could be on all three pieces of paper. So I'll do my 333, time it, scribble down my time. Okay, make sure you give yourself a little chart, like 333, so you remember what that time was for. I'm like, yeah, I think I could do better. I'm gonna try that again. 333. Write it down. Oh, I know I could do better. You know, you could stay with this as long as you want. And then you're like, okay, I'm good. I'm happy with that. That's my fastest time for today. I'll circle it. You don't have to go over there yet. Now I'm gonna work on my 363. Or whatever you choose. Maybe you wanna work the whole time on your cycle. So you're just using this as scratch paper. Yeah. Then when time's up, you'll just go to a marker. You can bring your pad of paper with you. You know, so you don't have to memorize your stuff. You're like, okay. And then kind of your name with your time either above or below. You don't have to circle it, but it looks kind of cool. Try to keep your circle close to your name so we don't waste a lot of space. All right, so we've had a lot of younger kids. That's why this is full. They don't do, first grade doesn't do this. First, second, third, none of them do the cycle. That's why there's less names up there. All right, so moving on. Station two is a little more complicated. So there's gonna be two teams. This is a relay. But you're not really relaying the other group that happens to be here. You're relaying for your best time as a relay team. Okay, so let me show you what that means. So Jack, can you come up here with your iPad and put your timer here? So you get this how you want. This is a 363 relay. So you get the finger timer up and then you wait here. Now let's pretend Kate and Luke and Jake are on their team. So just leave your iPad here for a second. In reality, you can put that on the table. You three come with me. Luke and Jake. And you're going to stand behind the red line. This is the single file. Okay. So the first person in the relay starts at the table. They don't have to race to the table. They're going to start at the table. They'll start the time. Then you have to do the hand tag at the red line. No one else touches the timer except Jake. Since he's last, when he gets here and does the 363, he'll stop the time. Then he'll bring the timer back, and they'll use their, I put the little boards, not scratch paper, but the little board, to record your time. Now you don't put it on the chart yet, because you want to see if you can get a faster time, faster time, faster time. Eventually, your fastest team relay time goes on the chart. When this station is done. Yeah.
Should we still write it down somewhere so we know what's our
Yeah, I put those little boards there to keep track of. It's just with that scratch paper. What are those called? Okay,
boards.
Yeah. So you just keep track of your time and then erase it. Emily?
So it's a 363 pattern?
Yeah. So 363 up and down, run back to your next player. 363 up and down, run back to the next player. Always have to go up and down, always have to go left to right. Please don't leave the red line until you're tagged. Now, the last thing on this is sometimes you're going to have four. Some teams might only have three. So clearly, whose time is going to be faster?
Three.
So on the chart, you're going to indicate if you're a team of three or a team of four. So yesterday, the Fortnite squad had four players.
Oh my God.
You have four players. Time. Then there's team. You can see three player teams. I already there's another chart up there that's already finished. So indicate how many players were on your team, right? So this team and this team, we don't have to race each other. We're just racing for our best.